In the shadow of the stars, a new space race is heating up. But this time, it's not just about planting a flag, it's about power, presence, and permanence. NASA's Artemis 3 mission, currently aiming for a mid-2027 launch, will send American astronauts to the moon for the first time in over 50 years. Meanwhile, an ambitious and strategic partnership between Russia and China is laying the groundwork to build a nuclear-powered research base on the lunar surface. As both sides eye the moon's south pole, rich in water, ice, and sunlight, the stakes couldn't be higher. A global contest is quietly unfolding, not only for who returns to the moon first, but for who controls the future of its resources, technology, and influence. The Artemis Path. At the center of the United States' lunar ambitions is Artemis 3, the most advanced moon mission since Apollo 17. Built around collaboration between NASA, SpaceX, ESA, and Axiom, this mission will launch aboard the Space Launch System, SLS, and carry four astronauts aboard the Orion spacecraft. Two astronauts will descend to the moon's surface using SpaceX's human landing system, Starship. Their target? The moon's south pole. This region, cloaked in shadow and mystery, is believed to contain frozen water, crucial for future human survival and deep space fuel production. Artemis 3's objectives go beyond planting a flag. Conduct the first crewed landing near the south pole, collect surface samples, and conduct scientific research. Deploy long-term monitoring instruments like LEMS and LEAF. Field test next-generation spacesuits by Axiom and Prada. Meanwhile, in the East, as NASA accelerates its lunar plans, Russia and China are taking a different approach, focused not on being first, but on staying for good. Together, they've signed a landmark agreement to build the International Lunar Research Station, ILRS, by the early 2030s. This proposed base is more than a scientific outpost. It's a geopolitical statement. ILRS is designed as a permanent installation, powered by nuclear energy and built for endurance through the harsh lunar nights. China's Chang'e missions have already mapped viable landing sites. Their aim is to establish infrastructure that secures access to water, resources, and strategic territory. This divergence of strategy between NASA's fast return and China-Russia's methodical construction shapes the new frontier. Parallel pursuits, a shifting balance. Rather than treat this as a rivalry of checklists, it's more revealing to examine the deeper contrast. Timing. NASA is aiming for a 2027 landing. China-Russia are targeting the 2030s. Energy. Artemis uses solar panels and batteries. ILRS plans to rely on a small nuclear reactor. Purpose. Artemis 3 reestablishes presence. ILRS aims to dominate through permanence. Location. Both are targeting the moon's south pole, a site rich in frozen water and strategic value. Partnerships. NASA works with ESA, SpaceX, and Axiom. Russia and China go forward through Roscosmos and CNSA. Obstacles. NASA faces spacecraft readiness issues. ILRS faces diplomatic isolation and budget constraints. These paths reflect not just technological competition, but two ideologies of exploration. The rapid demonstration of capability versus slow and deliberate occupation. The crossroads ahead. If all goes to plan, NASA will land humans first. But the true question isn't about the first footprint, it's about what happens after. With both sides targeting similar landing zones near permanently shadowed craters, potential friction looms. The moon may be international in theory, but in practice, the first to build may shape the rules. What happens if infrastructure overlaps? Will future bases observe boundaries or trigger new disputes in orbit? This is no longer just a race. It's a geopolitical standoff in slow motion. Conclusion: who shapes the moon, shapes the future. Artemis 3 represents a return, not just to the moon, but to leadership in space. In contrast, Russia and China are positioning themselves for permanence and influence. Both sides may land near the same frozen craters. Both may unfurl flags. But the side that builds infrastructure first, the one that powers up, stays, and thrives, will define what space exploration looks like for decades. And that future? It's being built right now. Subscribe for more Space Race documentaries as we track the next giant leap for humanity.